Right now, entire world is connected as one giant organ. Ever wonder how fiber optics really work? So fiber optic cables are tiny strands of glass. That's where your voice, your video, whatever you want to send, is sent through. Imagine you're watching a Netflix movie. How is this Netflix movie coming to your TV? What is going on at the Netflix data center? The movie is being converted into a set of electrical pulses, digitizing the signal. These electrical pulses then are sent to a laser through a device we call modulator. Each pulse which comes in turns the laser on, or if pulse is not there, turns the laser off. This laser light will then become a set of very short pulses, tiny pulses, which are blinking on and off. So by turning the laser light on and off multiple times, you are coding the information into the laser. It's like Morse code. And then this laser light, which has been converted and coded, is sent through a fiber. So imagine that in front of me, there's a fiber here, and then I'm coupling this light into the fiber. Once the light enters the fiber, it never leaves the fiber. It stays inside the fiber, no matter where the fiber is going. It can go on the land, or it can go in the ocean. It will stay inside that. So entire world is connected through these fiber optic cables, which are lying in the oceans. And hence, that video Netflix is showing can be seen anywhere in the world. That is the magic of fiber optics. If you're wondering how the fiber optic cables are made, we have to first make optical fibers. You start with a tube, a glass tube, which is about a meter long, a centimeter in diameter. And you put that glass tube in a furnace in a three-story tall building and let it melt. And with the gravity pulls it down, as it comes down, the fiber becomes thinner and thinner and thinner. At the end, at some point, it's thin enough that you let it wound on a drum. The reason the optical fibers are flexible, because they are very thin. If you take a thick piece of glass, it will become very hard and it will not be flexible. So diameter of this glass is 0.1 millimeter. To make a cable, you have to put this fiber inside a cable. And you don't put only one fiber, you put 5, 6, or 10 fibers inside the cable, because they will provide 10 different paths to communicate. The first fiber optic cable was laid in the Atlantic Ocean in 1988. In order to lay down a fiber optic cable in the ocean, you have to use huge ships from two ends will start laying down the cable at the bottom of the ocean. Eventually, they will meet in the middle, and that's where they will make the final connection. And it takes months of preparation and huge amount of money. These cables cost billions of dollars by the time they are done. So they are owned mostly by the very big companies like Google, Meta, Microsoft, Amazon. These are the companies that really own these cables because they are very expensive things. The internet would not be possible without fiber optic cables. By chance, the fiber optic cables came around 1988, 1990, and roughly 3 years later, internet started coming in. So there was a coincidence of two things, fiber optic cables and the internet. By now, fiber optics has become so common that the entire world is connected through fiber optic cables. They exist in the ocean, they exist on the land, and we have made multiple fiber optic networks. Fiber optic cables carry all kinds of data. This data can be for entertainment, audio, video, you're making phone calls, you're watching a video, but it is also the data that you create through banks, for example. All of your banking information, all of that is going through these fiber optic cables. Everything world does is being dependent on these cables. So right now, entire world is connected as one giant organ. Since we have all the infrastructure based on fiber optics, chances that fiber optics will remain as our main tool of communicating, sending, transmitting data for the next 30, 40 years are very large. All we need to do is keep improving the capacity, either by sending more signal, more data per second, or putting more fibers everywhere. As long as we do that, we can keep increasing capacity. Now, 50 years down the line, a new idea may come forward, just like from satellite, we switch to fiber optics, maybe something else that I cannot even think might come up in 50 years. The future will tell, and it's hard to predict.